Okay, in this video, I'm be creating a 3D model of a largemouth bass. Okay, before I get started on that, I already got the picture that I need that I'm gonna use for a reference, but there's a couple things I need to do on here before I can use this as a reference image. This right here needs to be something else. So what I usually do, if I could find it here, is take this patch tool right here and I'll cut out a section little by little. And I'll try to match it over here somewhere. See, I just managed to make part of the skin. I'm trying to get rid of this fin here because you really cannot model this with the fin in its way, because when you use the this as a texture for your fish, this fin will be permanently on the fish and you don't want that. Now there's a coloration problem here. I believe it can be fixed easily. Now, a couple other things I need to do here before I can start using this as the reference image. First of all, I want to make a save copy of this. I'm going to name this as texture, because I want to keep the reference image for when I want to make the fin and the eye placement. So I'm gonna copy that, take this right here. Pull this up to here. I'm not quite happy with that yet. I want to take this, put that about right there. This up here. I almost have to where I want this, but I'm still not happy with it. Okay. Now at this point, the model is ready. I mean, I should say the reference image is ready to be used. The texture image actually is ready to be used for later on. So I can save this over this right here. Now I'll go into 3ds Max. I'm going to place a plane right about here. Now, to get the dimension of the file I'm using, I just gotta pull it up. Gotta remember to resize this after I'm done. I think this is the one that I was want to use. Okay, 3000 by 1425, so So this should be 3,000. Now, if I'm correct, it should have the correct resolution for this this size. So I'm gonna push this button right here to zoom out on all viewports. I don't need these grids. Also, I'm gonna get rid of these lines. Change this to different color. Now open up the material editor by pushing M on my keyboard. Now normally I use the slate material editor, but for what I want to do is I'm just going to go to the compact editor. Just grab the bitmap. Okay, I'll go to my folder here. Way down here in the bottom. Should have renamed it though, because this is a lot of scrolling. So open this up. Click the plane. And paste it to the. Or say apply it. Now I can see it here just fine. But really, I don't want to model from here. So on this side, I am going to do default shading. And I'm going to zoom in. Actually, I might do the line in the center. But I got to put this as edge faces, so I can see it's pretty centered right down this. So I'm gonna start out by creating a cylinder right here by the tail. Okay, I gotta reposition this. Now normally people would just go here into the properties, if I could find it. Object properties, they'll click on see through. But I don't go that route, because you don't have a consistent, well, it is consistent, but you kind of want to adjust. I'm going to turn this on because it allows me to rotate this at a perfect angle. Also, I'll get rid of these segments here. Now I'll go back into the material editor and I'll apply this to a cylinder that I just created. I usually put this about 30. we could see perfectly right through that. So once I'm happy to where I am with this, I'll go to edible poly and then vertices, or say vertex, and I'll start trying to shape this out as best I can. Now I will add, first thing, I gotta fix this edge loop. Molly, I'm gonna right click on Swift Loop, and I'm gonna attach it to my toolbar, which is up here now. So I don't need this open anymore. So I'm gonna click this. I want to put one about right here. This way I can come in here, just adjust this just a little bit. I actually just need to adjust this down here a little bit. Okay, now I'm gonna select all these faces right here. But I'm going to Alt and select the faces behind here. This way I have the front faces selected but none of the side faces. If you see here, that I have only the front faces selected. So all I have to do is select the front. And this side face is over here. Control Alt, drag, release. Okay, now I can start shaping this out. I use extrude. I'm gonna put this over here so it's out of the way. Some more. When you're done with shaping the fish out, I would recommend scaling it down a little bit, because what this is going to create is a very, very fat object. You don't really want that. Okay, here needs some change in here. Otherwise, I'm going to be grabbing that area, which I don't want. Now back to polygon mode, select, extrude. Grab these polys, these vertices up here, drag them up to this line. Okay, extrude some more. this, I hear it's kind of a little too far down. It gets pretty fast afterwards when you start knowing what you're doing. It's best to try to get this in the proper place for when you go to apply the texture to the model.
Station, the USA station, and it's talking English, French on there.
Huh. When I get to this point right here, I think I'm going to increase the polygon count. And, first, I'll just leave that where it's at. Work on the fins here. The back and the top fin, and also the tail. And before texturing it, I'm going to probably bring it into to ZBrush, so I can try to sculpt out the lips and the eyes, and plus the gill plate. Now it's hard to see on here, but if I go here, you're gonna see that the lips right here has defined shape to it. The same with the gill plate. You could see the small details all around. So that's the way I'm gonna bring it into ZBrush and just try to sculpt out the finer details of this fish. Even I'm gonna try to do the details on the fins as well. Just gonna get to a point where you don't have to keep shaping this out, but it'd be wise to have a little type of shape up here. Otherwise, it's gonna be just flat up here. Same thing down here. There's a little bit of shape here as well. There we go. Whoops. I forgot to push OK. Accept the changes. Well, actually, this don't have to be like this down here. It can hang down a little bit more because it's the fin that's right there. It's in a way, but I have ways to get around that. Still not right, so this gotta be adjusted again. Trying to go as slow as possible, just so you guys can keep up, but also I'm trying to make sure that I don't mess up anything because it's not hard, really. I'm not too worried about the alignment of the polygons, because it's gonna look good regardless. Now some of these I'm going to fix. Not too happy with it. Just that one polygon right there. Okay, something happened here. Somehow lost my placement. So it's a good idea to try to keep these right, at least over here, kind of straight as possible. Because when we start cutting out the gills, you want to make sure you don't have no deformation. Otherwise, it ain't going to look right when you apply the smooth modifier on here. Here there's like a little bit of a difference. I wish the shape is kind of differently. Let's grab these right here. And that's about right. You're probably wondering how I'm gonna do this with the eyes. I think I don't need too much there. If I grab this, drag this into the center, I'll have a placement for the eye socket already. This also will get me the shape that I'm looking for. Right here. Okay, I'm gonna keep the extruding. I'm gonna extrude up to here about, and I'm gonna try to create the mouth. But before I get to that point, I am going to save this. Sometimes it's kind of pretty unpredictable how the mouth's going to turn out. At least to me it is. I'm just gonna take this and just drag out this little bit. I'm gonna keep the same shape because I'm gonna cut this right here up to here. So let's see how it looks. Now it's kind of hard to see because it's see-through. So, go to Material Editor, drag this all the way to 100%. And if you want, you can hide the plane so you can get an idea what your model looks like. As I said, it's really kind of really wide. That's kind of easy to fix. The only problem with doing this is that the size of the mouth is completely lost. I can drag out here and try to widen this out just a little bit. Is good enough. I'm gonna hide this. Change its color because I don't like that purple. I know for a fact the fish ain't that wide. Save this. So next time when you're ready to save, all you have to do is save as, if you want to save this in segments. You push this button right here. This will create automatically a new save. It will be 02. So go ahead. See, it changed to 02 up here. Kind of. Alright. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So on this part, be going to hear. Put this at 30 again. Okay. Go to the modifier stack and find symmetry. Excuse me. Now this icon right here shows end results, so turn this on, go to the edge, excuse me. So it's kind of hard to see with this orange edges in the way, so to get rid of that, go all the way down here to subdivision surface. Click here, show cage, uncheck that. So now you don't have that in a way. So I'm gonna save real quick. I'm gonna go to cut. Now this goes all the way down to here. Try to follow along where the mouth should be. Don't be afraid to okay, now back up to here. In this viewport, now hide the plane if you have to. Now there's going to be a little issue right up here where it's not connected, so make the cut on top and place that about right there. Now you have to reshape this for certain, cause the lips ain't going to look right. Like I said, the way this the lips are on this fish is makes it kind of a little difficult to model it out. That's why I said to save on something like this, cause you might have to improvise to get this right. So, to here, all the way down. Here, and right to here. Now, according to this, it looks right, but for the top, it don't. So again, go to the front, to the perspective viewport, and hide the plane. Again, there's you don't see the that it's connected. So click on vertices and go go all the way across, right about here. Okay, now we can basically go back to here, turn it back to 100, and see what happens here. Now I'm gonna plan to correct this somehow, but for now, grab these. You can, you don't have to delete these. I usually do just try to extrude it, not outward, but inward. So I'll drop this down about to here. And apply and make another extrude. This is where I might want to go up at the top viewport so I can see where this is going. Okay, I'll make another extrude. The best to make some segments up in here. Also, this will be a big help for later on when you want to create the opening and also the tongue for the mouth. This would be a simple fix. I'll just pull this here. This one out a little bit, and then this one. Might want to grab this, pull out. Now you should have the basic shape of the mouth. Adjust this a little bit more. Go up to here, on top viewport again. Pull back. And one more time, extrude. This time, I'm gonna pull back a little further. Point where you can actually try to flatten this out. And you want to try to extrude it one more time. Mm-hmm. trying to figure if I'm gonna have a problem with this mouth yet or not. No, I think it's this one right here. It clearly shows the opening on the mouth right here. Just keep going and see what happens. Technically, this ain't working out because of the way this is right here. Because it looks like the that it's creating something, but don't look right. Like I said, I saved it for a reason. Curious what this is gonna look like, so I'm gonna add a subdivision modifier. Up this to 2. Not looking right, so I'm gonna undo what I did. Try to do this a different way because this ain't working out. Alright, I'm gonna pause this a minute so I can figure this out and I'll get back to you guys. Well, I'm gonna try something here. I'm gonna grab all these polygons and it's gonna delete them. And grab that. I don't know if this can work or not, but I'm hoping it does. Pull back. I'm probably gonna get the same result. Thank you. No, I don't know. I'm trying to figure this out. Maybe if I do this right now and try to pull this in here. That ain't working. There's gotta be something doing wrong here. I'll make a part two of this and see if I can figure this out now. Just redo it and record it. Anyways, I hope that you guys are able to follow along. I do apologize for this problem in his mouth. Anyways, like I said, once I figure it out, I'll make the second video. Thank you for watching. Bye.